Hi again, everyone. Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation, I'm going to continue my series of videos on complex numbers. Now, in previous presentations, I introduced a way of measuring the size of complex numbers, known as the modulus. And I'm going to do an example in this presentation. So let me share my screen with you and we can get underway. Okay, so here we are asked to prove for all complex numbers z and w that the modulus of a product is just the product of the moduli. Now, this comes from this little table here that I showed you in the previous presentation. It's just down here. And I said I'd prove some of these in forthcoming videos. Okay, so just to refresh our memory, if you have a complex number z with a equals a plus bi, then to get the modulus of z, it's just the sum of the squares of a and b, and you take the square roots. And geometrically speaking, if you plot z in the complex plane or on an Argand diagram, then the modulus is the distance from the point z to the origin. Okay, and it's just Pythagoras' theorem. Okay, that's how where this this formula comes from. And I talked about that in a previous video. Okay, so how do we prove this? Okay, well, let's introduce some notation first. I'm going to let z be, say, a plus bi, where a and b are real. And we're going to say let w equals c plus di, where c and d are real. Okay, so what we're going to do is start with the left-hand side of what we want and hopefully do some operations on it, and hopefully we end up with the right-hand side. So let's label this identity. Say, call it star. All right, so the left-hand side, LHS of star, is just the modulus of the product of z with w. Okay, so let's write that out in the Cartesian form. What I'm going to do is try to simplify what's inside the modulus signs. Okay, so I can multiply that out just by distributing normally and remembering, of course, that I squared equals negative 1. Okay, so when I expand this, I'm going to get a times c, bi times di, so I squared will be negative 1. So the real part of the product is going to be ac minus bd. Okay, and then let's do the calculations where the i's are left. So you're going to have adi plus bci, and if I factor out the i, I'll get what's left here. Okay, and essentially I want to take a look at the modulus of this expression. Okay, so to take the modulus, I look at the real part, I look at the imaginary part, I square them, add them together, and take the square root. Okay, so I'm going to get a bit of a mess now. Okay, so it's looking like a bit of a mess. Okay, now, hopefully this will simplify, and it will. Now, if I expand each of these brackets, I'm going to get some squared terms and some non-squared terms. Okay, let's look at the non-squared terms because they're actually going to cancel. The non-squared term out of this is going to be 2 times this times this. So you're going to get negative 2ACBD. The non-squared term out of this is going to be this times 2. 2ADBC. They're the same expressions. So the non-squared terms out of this and the non-squared terms out of this will cancel, okay? Okay, and I'll just be left with, okay, let me say that again, because I think my camera froze for a second. If you look at the non-square terms in the first bracket, you're going to get 2 times that, so negative 2ACBD, and the non-square term is going to be 2ADBC. They're the same things, so they're going to cancel. You're going to be left with a whole bunch of squareds. Okay, so we're going to have AC squared plus BD squared plus AD squared plus BC squared. Okay, so what I'm trying to do now is trying to simplify this as much as I can to try to come up with something like this. Okay, well, if you look, say if I take a common factor of A squared out of these two terms and say a B squared out of these two terms, then I get the following. And I can combine these because I've got a common factor of C squared plus D squared. Okay, so now let's just check what we want. We want to have this times this, okay? So if I use the square root properties, I've got this and this here now. This is the modulus of Z. This is the modulus of W. So I've got the product that I wanted. And that is the right-hand side of star. Okay, so we've started with the left-hand side, we've done some manipulation to it, and we've got the right-hand side of star. Hence, the left-hand side and the right-hand side have got to be equal for all complex numbers Z and W. So for all Z and W in the set of complex numbers. That's it. Okay, so we've proved our identity. Well, that's a proof of one of the identities that I showed you in the previous presentation. I might get back to some more of them. In forthcoming videos, I'm going to connect the length of the modulus with the conjugate. And in particular, I'm going to prove that the conjugate of a product is the product of the conjugate. So it's sort of a little bit similar to what we did today with the modulus. Okay, so I hope you can tune in for that presentation. If you have any questions, any comments, you can put them in the comment section below. So thanks for watching. Hope you can join me again. Bye.